One great way of using the Vevox survey feature is for your asynchronous sessions. So first of all you need to do is to log into your Vevox account and create a session. Through the session, click on the survey tab here on the left-hand side, and then you can create your survey through here. I've actually already created a survey for the purpose of today's video, but if I click on this arrow here, we can see all of the questions that we've got included in my survey. So we've got 5 different questions, and they are a mixture of multiple choice, open text, and star rating. One great thing about the survey feature is that you're able to add as many questions as you need, and then when you are ready to start your survey, you will just need to come down to the bottom and click Start Survey. This then pushes the survey out to your participants ready to take their answers. So I've actually got the participant view open at the top here. So if I just open that and then click on the clipboard icon, as a participant, I can go through and I can send in my answers. So if I just do that quickly now, and then as the presenter, going back into my dashboard, I can check the progress of the survey. So to do that, I just need to go to the data tab here on the left-hand side, go to survey results, scroll down to my survey that I've got open, and I can check the answers as they come in from all of my participants. So you can see here as well, we've got the total responses from each participant. So it's a good way of knowing when to close your survey. Another great thing of the survey feature is that you're able to have it open for as long as you need. Pretty much what I mentioned at the beginning, so when you're running an asynchronous session, you can launch your survey and you can send it to your participants and you can have it running in the background, meaning that you can check the knowledge before your next live session, or you can also gather feedback as to how they have been getting on with the content that you've released them earlier that week. That's pretty much it with asynchronous surveys, but once you have got all of your responses, you'll need to come in here to the survey tab again and click Stop Survey. Cool, I hope you found this video useful, and please let us know if you've got any questions.